Adeola, that's right, it's been real and I'm keeping it real here. My first story this week, Africans top the New York Marathon. Give it up, y'all, for Africans in the city. First prize, a Kenyan. Second prize, a Kenyan. The third prize, Ethiopian. The fourth prize, an Ethiopian. The fifth position, a Moroccan. Y'all, people, I'm like, Africans are really doing it big up in here. And the sixth position, people, went to an American guy. Give it up for the brother. The brother really tried. The thing is, when it comes to marathon, Africans don't play. We may not take all the, you know, everything else, but when it comes to marathon, we don't play, especially Kenyans. So since when does UK get to tell Ghana what to legalize in its constitution?
Poor African countries that don't support gay rights. The Daily Mail Online reports British Prime Minister David Cameron is trying to take a, quote, gay rights crusade to the third world. The British government is also threatening to punish Ghana and Uganda for their laws outlawing homosexuality.
Seriously, it's about time Africans wake up and stop depending on foreign aid. I took a look at the natural resources that UK has compared with the one that Ghana has. I don't see gold. Do you see silver? Do you see diamond in that list? People, chalk! Seriously, that's a natural resources, chalk! Do you know that in Ghana, there is gold, there is silver, there is diamond, all in one place? Do you guys know that Ghana is the second largest cocoa producer in the whole world? Well, the list goes on and on and on and on, and I'm like, whoa! Ghana is really blessed, and it's not just Ghana, it's all African countries are really, really, really blessed. So I'm like, we just need to make good use of our natural resources, people. For how long? For how long would we depend on foreign aid? I say Ghana should make her own decision, and no one should tell her what to legalize. Even though I'm not a Ghanaian by birth, I'm still a Ghanaian by friendship. Can I say that? Talking about waking up, Africans, do you know that Americans are occupying everywhere in the US? To protest, they occupy Wall Street, San Francisco, Phoenix, you name it, Vancouver, they occupy everywhere. And I'm like, Africans need to start occupying someplace. Occupy Oshodi, occupy Accra, occupy Nairobi, occupy somewhere until we get the attention of our leaders, people. The thumbs up this week goes to Rwanda, whose national currency recently appreciated by 0.9% against the US dollars. Way to go, Rwanda! Way to go! I'm like, that small Rwanda? I mean, sorry, my bad. That great Rwanda? Seriously? If Rwanda can do that, other African countries need to wake up. Thumbs down this week goes to Zimbabwean President Mugabe, who has spent so far more than $20 million on medical treatments abroad this year alone. We're talking about taxpayers' money. African leaders need to stop going overseas for medical treatment. All the monies that you guys are stealing, I mean, all the money that you guys are saving, use it to build some kind of good hospital in your country. You won't believe that African leaders go to India for medical treatment. I'm like, issue. I hate when someone is saying that he's been tossed and people don't believe him. You know, just take a look at what I'm talking about.
My name is Pina Thompson.
Okay, and you're going to sing?
He touched me. Jesus touched me.
Oh, he touched me. Okay.
Now, Peter, do you feel you have what it takes to
win
this?
Yes, I have it. I have it.
You have it. You know
yes,
you have it.
I knew it.
Okay. So, he touched me.
He touched me. Jesus touched me.
Oh,
Lord, Joe, it has filled my soul.
Jesus.
Sometimes I fall in
love. Why do I miss Michael Jackson right now?
Peter.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is not a comedy routine, is this? Are you serious?
I'm very serious.
You're very serious?
Yes.
Peter, don't do this again. Ever again in life. Stay away from music as far as you possibly can. Because there's something wrong.
Don't press
me. By the
way,
it's a no for Sunday best. It's a no.
You think?
He touched me.
Yeah, okay.
He touched me.
Sure he did.
Okay, but you have to go now.
Can you believe those judges did not lie? He tossed him, you know? He really tossed him. The guy's been tossed, people. Before I leave today, I want you guys to see a little bit of Obudukatu Ranch in Cross River State of Nigeria. It's a beautiful place. If you're planning on visiting Nigeria, that's a place you should see. Take a look.
You are so beautiful. Can't you see? Everything I hope for.
Alright, y'all. It's been real. I'm keeping it real right up in here. And until next week, I'm gonna see y'all later. Peace out.